Presidential bet Panfilo Lacson unfazed by a supposed demolition job being planned against him. The senator claims their camp received information about a group of people who is planning to launch a black propaganda against him. Lacson believes these people want to get back at him because they felt alluded to in his anti-corruption crusade.
Meron daw nasasaktan doon sa magnanakaw narrative namin ni Senate President. So ibig sabihin, may tinatablan. Hindi ko alam kung sino. No? Merong pangalan lumabas pero I'm not at liberty to mention naman din name kasi sabi ko nga binabalidate pa namin. We'll still continue with that narrative. After all, yun naman talaga yung problema ng bansa natin. So hindi kami titigil. Ganun pa rin yung aming para ipapamuka sa ating mga kababayan, sa aming mga sorties, pag may mga dialogue.
Respect the freedom of private citizens. That's the appeal of Vice President Lenny Robredo's camp after the Commission on Elections took down campaign materials displayed in private properties. Election lawyer Romulo Macalintal said COMELEC has no power to remove such items posted by non-candidates in their properties, even if they are over the prescribed sizes without due process. He adds a class suit can be filed before the Supreme Court over what he described as COMELEC's unconstitutional policy.
Pwede nga class suit yan eh. They can file a class suit before the Supreme Court para yung mga other parties ay makasama na. Papasukin mo yung bahay ng tao kahit wala kang warrant of arrest. Papasukin mo nang wala kang warrant of seizure. Ay bakit yung mga granada at baril, mga kung ano ng mga illegal drugs, hindi mo mapasok without any warrant? Pagkatapos itong ganito mga campaign materials, in the exercise of freedom expression, papasukin mo nang walang warrant? Siguro dapat mag-isip-isip naman kayo mga taga-COMELEC.
Robredo's spokesperson, meanwhile, says the vice president is very concerned over what happened.
As a lawyer, as isang public servant na talagang mahalagang mahalaga sa kanya yung exercise ng karapatan ng bawat mamamayan, lalo na nitong freedom of speech, malalim yung kanyang concern. Mula simula, sinasabi natin na people's campaign ito. Ibig sabihin, hindi lang yung mga tradisyonal na bahagi ng kampanya, kundi mga volunteers ay kumikilos, nagse-self-fund, nagse-self-initiate ng kanilang mga pagkilos para sa kanilang mga kandidato. And itong ganitong klaseng aksyon ng COMELEC, parang may pagpigil nun.
Presidential aspirant Manny Pacquiao shrugging off criticisms that he is not fit for the presidency. Pacquiao says he has more to offer than other contenders because he does not only make promises, he actually makes good on those promises. He adds he is not like traditional politicians who only serve their personal interests.
Kaya nga ako tumakbo dahil sawa na ako doon sa mga pangako ng mga politician eh. Karamihan, hindi naman lahat pero karamihan puro mga pangako pero walang nangyayari. Kaya tayo umiikot at bumababa at in-explain natin mabuti na mali yung perception at binabalita ng ating mga taong naiinggit sa atin na wala akong alam. At ako nga, sinasabi ko nga sa kanila na dapat talaga ang ating bansa magkaroon ng master plan.
The fighting senator also has this to say to critics who believe he might be on the brink of backing out of the race to Malacanang.
I am not a weak leader. Hindi ako weak na tao. I am a fighter. So, sinong nag-isip na atras ako? Baka yung mga nag-isip na ganon, yun ang atras. Para malaman ninyo, si Manny Pacquiao, laging palaban. Laging palaban sa buhay, basta nasa tama.
A campaign strategist says presidential candidate Bongbong Marcos has every advantage in his campaign, evident in recent election surveys. A new SWS poll commissioned by the Stratbase ADR Institute show the son of the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos topping the survey with 50% of respondents saying they would vote for him. A distant second place was Vice President Lenny Robredo with 19%. But Alan Herman also says, aside from political machinery, Marcos seems to be projecting his father's image through his mannerisms, invoking nostalgia for their family supporters. He adds historical revisionism is also playing a part in this year's presidential race.
Campaigns are always just a mixture of four M's. It's man, message, machinery, and money. And having said that, it seems that Marcos Jr. Seems to have the advantage in perhaps every M. So that could explain his lead in all of the survey firms' pre-election ratings. The analogy is that a Hitler Jr. will win in Germany. The term historical revisionism gets bandied about a lot, wherein exactly that, the reasons for behind that EDSA revolution and what caused the uproar during that time from the generation that preceded us, has been completely twisted. And sadly, often the loudest voice gets the most attention, and the loudest voice often gets mistaken for the truth. And that's exactly what happened. Their voice is loud, it's pervasive.
An update now on the campaign trail. Manila Mayor Isko Moreno is in northern Luzon to woo voters in the bailiwick of survey frontrunner Bongbong Marcos. His schedule today includes touring the province of La Union. Moreno is not bothered by the results of recent pre-election surveys, saying he will do everything he can to win the trust of Filipinos.
Sa dami ng hirap na dinanas ko, siguro it teaches me so many lessons na magpursige sa buhay, at kung gusto mo may makamit ka, pagsikapan mo. And we will try to be in places like Northern Luzon and the Southern Luzon. The Ilocanos, the Bicolanos, the Cabiteños, they are all Filipinos. The same thing with the sa lugar sa Mindanao, Cebuanos, and so on. It's everybody is a Filipino.
The tandem of Bongbong Marcos and Sara Duterte Carpio continue their campaign in Ilocos Sur. They were joined by their Senate slate, including actor Robin Padilla, despite Marcos's remark that he's not part of their Magic 12. In a campaign rally, Duterte Carpio vows to continue the programs of her father's administration.
Gusto natin ipakita sa buong mundo na malakas ang Pilipinas dahil nagkakaisa tayong lahat. At ang unity din po ang may commitment na ituloy ang mga reforma na nasimulan ng Duterte administration.